Welcome back. So where we left off is there was 1,000 people who all needed, let's say, $1 million loans each, and they were all going to pay 10% on their loans. And they borrowed it from this bank. You know, it's kind of a standard commercial bank. And this bank says, well, you know, I just handed out $1 billion, and I'm getting these interest payments, and my, you know, vaults are empty. I want to have money back in my vaults, or, you know, I want to have money back on my balance sheet. So I'm going to sell these loans. I'm going to bundle them all together and sell them to this investment bank. And now, what is this investment bank going to do with these loans, and why is it doing it? So let me delete this. So we had the investment bank. I randomly picked the color green, but I think it is appropriate for the investment bank. So now I have all of the, you know, me. That's a little smiley face. You know, there's 1,000 of me. And we are now going to pay the 10%. We're now going to make all of our mortgage payments, that 10% payment, to this bank, this investment bank. But the investment bank, they're not in the business of servicing loans or keeping loans on their balance sheets. So what they do is they create a corporation. They create an entity, though, you know, maybe a special purpose entity, whatever you want to call it. So they create a company. Let me make that in purple, another color. So they create this company. And what they do is they will take this $1 billion, not $1 billion, they take their rights to these payments that they got, right? They paid $1 billion to that first bank in order to get the payments from all of these people. And they say, you know what, the rights on that, on those payments, right, that's the asset. They bought all these loans. The rights on those payments, we are now going to transfer to this special purpose entity, to this other corporation. So now everyone is going to, essentially, all their money, all their mortgage payments are going to be funneled into this entity, right? And this is a corporation, and so what the bank will do is issue shares in this corporation. So let's say that it issues, let's say for simplicity, 100 shares. So there's 100 shares. So what's in this corporation? There's the entire corporation gets the mortgage payments on the $1 billion in loans, right? It has $1 billion of loans outstanding, and it's going to get 10% a year. So it's going to get 100 million per year, right? Because it's 1,000 loans out there. It's going to get 100 million per year for 10 years, and at the end of the 10 years, it's also going to get $1 billion, right? That's its asset it has. Its asset is the rights on those payment streams that are going to come into this corporation. And then it has 100 shares. So if you, the way I think about it is you can split this company 100 ways. And I'm doing this to further confuse you. So what is each of those, the owner of each of those shares, what does it entitle them to? Well, it entitles me to 1/100th of what this corporation gets. So each share, so if I have a share, let's make it look, it looks like a share, a stock certificate, I'm going to get 1/100th of this thing. And normally you wouldn't have 100 shares. You would have, let's say, 1 million shares. Actually, let me make it 1 million shares, because I think that's in some strange way more realistic. So let's say there are 1 million shares. So if there are 1 million shares, each share will get 1/1,000,000th of the cash flow stream that's entitled to this entity. So instead of getting $100 million every year, it gets 1/1,000,000th of that. So it gets $100 per year. And then on the last year, instead of getting $1 billion, it gets $1,000. So what the bank will do is it'll take these shares and then it'll sell it to the general public. It'll, you know, it'll IPO it, essentially. You can think of it that way. And tons of people will buy it, especially hedge funds and pension funds and mutual funds and bond investors. And it's just important to think about how the money is flowing. So now when they sell these shares in this entity, people are going to give them, well, hopefully more than what they paid for it, right? Maybe there's a lot of demand for this type of asset where I get this type of income stream. So maybe once they sell all the shares, they get, I don't know, they get $1.1 billion for them, right? So this is the investors. And the investors collectively buy these shares for $1.1 billion. Essentially, let's say they paid $1.1 billion for 1 million shares. So they paid $1,100 per share, right? $1,100 per share. Each of the investors paid $1,100 for each of the shares. So then $1.1 billion goes into the special purpose entity. And if you think about it, the bank made out like a bandit, right? Because the bank paid $1 billion for the rights to these mortgage payments. And it's getting $1.1 billion from the investors. And all the bank has to do is kind of set this whole legal structure up and service the loans. Actually, it doesn't even have to service the loans. We'll go into that later. So let me summarize, I guess, just because I know this can be a little bit of a daunting subject. Let me summarize. So, and let me use this purple I don't like. It's a little bit. Anyway, so you have tons of investors. So each of these is an investor. A borrower. All of these people need to buy houses. These are all smiley faces. These are all smiley faces, right? They all need to buy houses, and then they collectively get $1 billion, right? $1 million each, and they each use that $1 million to buy their house, to buy their relative house. And then that $1 billion initially came from, you know, just their local bank. And then when the $1 billion came from that local bank, all the mortgage, the payments, the interest payments went to the bank. But then an investment bank came along and said, well, no, I want to buy the rights to those payments. An investment bank came along and says, well, I'm going to give you $1 billion, $1 billion. And now, instead of you getting the payments, I get the payments. And then the bank sets up a special purpose entity. Essentially, it sells a bunch of shares. Let's say it sells 1 million shares, 1 million shares. And let's say it was able to sell each of those shares for $1,100, right? From the investing public. So it's able to sell each of them so it raises $1.1 billion, right? So the value of this company is $1.1 billion that now goes to the bank. And now the payment stream, instead of going to, let me do a different color. Now the payment stream goes to the special purpose entity instead of the bank. And the bank essentially made out like a bandit because it paid $1 billion and it got 1.1, so it made $100 million. Just for doing this transaction. I'm not saying that's how much a bank actually would make, but this shows you why every person is kind of what they're doing in this value chain. And as I said before, this bank also probably did something similar. They probably took some fees or sold the loans for slightly more than they issued the loans for. So these shares, each of these 1 million shares, you know, these shares that I said, this is a mortgage-backed security. Mortgage-backed security. And it makes sense. It's a security. A security is an ownership that's tradable in a company. And that company has the right to payments that are secured by mortgages. So if all these people promised they would pay, and they're going to pay to this special purpose entity, but if by chance one of these people lose their jobs or they can't pay or for whatever reason, the instead of the payments, this entity is going to have the rights to their property. And that's why we say that it's a mortgage-backed security. So it's not just a promise to get money. The money is actually backed by people's mortgages. And of course, then this entity is going to, if this guy defaults on his loan, he's one of 1 million. So, you know, statistically, you might be able to predict that. I don't want to put too much stock in these statistical models. Then this entity will just have that property auctioned off or sold, and then it'll just, you know, the cash flow will come back to it. So that's what a mortgage-backed security is. Hopefully I didn't confuse you too much. My next presentation, I'm going to take it to a further level of confusion and show you what a collateralized debt obligation is. And then I'll do a more philosophical video on why these things even exist and why they're useful and why people may benefit or may not benefit from these things.